Hello everyone, this is Kalyan and today I will discuss a use case which looks pretty simple at first. All you wanted to serve your static file from CDN. Pretty simple, right? You can simply use Angular CLI's deploy URL flag to change your script and CSS path during build. But what about if you have multiple environment? Let's see these problems. In this diagram, you can see if you are using Angular CLI's deploy URL, you need a build for every environment. But ask yourself, is there any change in your code? Why do you need multiple builds for your environments? Let's check the next diagram, where you will just build once and send packages to your enterprise private npm and just deploy to every environment. But how that is possible? I'll show you how. Let's get started. If you are following along, this code is already available in my repo. And you can also check how to set up an Angular universal project from this video. In the .env file, I made few changes. I have added bb underscore env properties, which can be dev, qa, st or prod. And also, I have changed the bb underscore cdn underscore url path, which is pointing to my DigitalOcean CDN. If you want to know how to set up environment variable, you can watch this video, which I shared earlier. Next, I have created a module folder in which I have added a module called Injector module. In this module, I have imported the Injector service, which I'll go through shortly. I have also added the service inside the provider. Also, this module has been imported into server module. This is very important as we want our script and CSS to be loaded from server only. Also, I have added the module inside import declaration. Apart from that, I have also imported the injector service. Then, I have created and exported a function called onBootstrap, which holds application reference and our injector service instance. Application reference have an observable called isTable, which I have subscribed to know the application state, and then I have executed the inject method, which I have written inside my injector service to inject the files. Inside the ng module decorators provider, I have added my function as a factory and also passed the injector service and application reference as dependency. Pretty simple, right? Now let's see our injector service. This is a simple service where I have used platform state to get the current document state. I have used an interface for my environment variables. Now, within our main method inject, within document constant, I am checking the document state. With rendererfactory, I have created a custom renderer where I have used view encapsulation to none. I have two constant to get the body and head, as for CSS it will be injected in head and all other script will be injected to the body. If the current document state don't have a body tag, our script will throw an error, else it will move forward. In the config, I am getting the config object which holds all the environment variable passed from our server provider. If you are confused what exactly is happening, I recommend you to check my Angular Universal Setup and Environmental Setup videos. In the constant env, I am checking if the current env is dev, then send as a blank path which will load the files directly from the disk directory as a relative URL. But for any other environment, it will create the URL, concatenating the URL defined in environment and which is CDN URL in our case. And then it will take package version as a folder name. I have taken this version from npm package version. In our case, it is 0.0.2. Now, I am creating the script and CSS URL using our custom renderer. You can see the files in this directory for which we have to create all these injections. I have added this script multiple times for only demonstration purpose. But please create a method which will take this from an array and create all these injections. Runtime.js constant holds the whole URL structure and the rest lines are self-explanatory, where I am creating a custom script, setting attribute as text/JavaScript and appending to the body at the end. For CSS, we are just injecting it to the head. Now, if we build, the next problem we will encounter is the index.html, which is output of a build. We'll already have a script tag generated from Webpack, which we don't want in our case, as we will inject those dynamically. I have created a script directory and added a script which will simply copy the index.html from your source directory and place it in our dist browser directory without adding any script or CSS tags, and added these scripts in our package.json once the build completes. Now let's run our solution. You can see all our files are coming from our CDN. If you see the source, you can see it's indeed rendered from server. In my CDN, I have created this directory based on our package.json version, in our case 0.0.2, and uploaded the files from this directory. If you now run a Google Lighthouse audit report, you can see a great performance result. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.